H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Welcome to another video of H2K Infosys. In this particular video, I'll show you some examples of exceptions that we have taken in the last video. So the agenda of this particular video is to show you examples with Eclipse. The first example that I'm going to show you is how does an exception come. And in this particular example, I will take the case of an unchecked exception. So let us open up Eclipse. And I'll create a new project called as session number 32. Click on finish and say no. So in this particular project, I'm going to create a package by the name of exceptions only. And I'm going to create a class file by the name of, let's say, example of exception to depict it as a session that I'm going to take out here right now. So let us create a, how do an exception come? So this is a typical example of exceptions that will be thrown out by the compiler, and the example that I'm taking will be an example of a unchecked exception. So how does an exception come? Generally, exception comes because of non-understanding of the coding structure or the logic of the code by the developer, or a mistake by the developer, or by the carelessness of the developer. Then let's say we have an integer a which is equal to 20, and then we have integer b which is equal to 30, and I basically put down the value of a plus b into c is equal to a plus b, for example, and I want a sysout statement in which I want to get the result of the variable c. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to just write down the value of c is concatenate this with the variable c out here. So I get the result when I save the class file and run it. It's pretty easy. The result will be 50 at this point of time in the console of Eclipse. So let us wait for the result. Sometimes the Eclipse becomes slow because of certain reasons, and that's fine. So I'm getting the result as 50 right now. So after that, let's say I have an integer d which is equal to, let's say, 30 divided by 20, or rather I would say b divided by a, and I want to get the result of d. So I'll just do a sysout and copy this particular line of code which is given out here, just change the variable name and call out the variable out here. So I'll get the result as 30 divided by 20 is 1. 1 is the result. So if I save the class file and run it, I'll get the result as value of d is 1. Now let's say there is a carelessness mistake by the coder, or a mistake by the coder. So let's say what he does is he defines a variable e which is equal to, let's say, 70. And there's a variable f which is nothing but e divided by 0, for example, and then you have a SISO statement. I can just basically copy this particular part just to not to waste time. So the value of variable f will be f, and then there's a variable g which is equal to a into b, and you want to get the result of variable G. So I'll just copy this and get a value of G is G. So let us run the class file. So when we run the class file, we see that we are getting the result of variable C, which is 50. That's fine. And the result of variable D, which is B divided by A, that is 30 divided by 20, that is 1. But after that, there's an exception being thrown out. And the exception is thrown out at the console of Eclipse. And the exception is in thread main. That means it is present in the main method. Thread is nothing but in which particular method the exception is present. That is what it is showing us. And what is the type of exception? It is called as arithmetic exception. This is the type of exception. And the message of the exception is divide by zero. And where is the exception present? At the exceptions package. And this package has a class file called example of exception. And is this particular class file, there's a method called main, in which in this particular line number 14, the exception is present. So if I click on this particular link, I'll get the exception line, that is line number 14. And why is the exception coming? The exception is coming because you are dividing E by 0. So 70 by 0. Anything divided by 0 is infinity. Infinite result is not there. There's no valuation for infinity. So that is why the compiler of Java will throw you not the value or anything else. What it is going to throw you is this kind of result, that is nothing but the type of exception it is. And where is the exception present? It is in line number 14 and the message of the exception. So this is the type of exception, this is the message of the exception, and this is the line number in which the exception is present, line number 14. This kind of exception is called as a unchecked or a uncaught or a runtime exception, because when I have written this particular line of code out here in line number 14, okay, the compiler is not able to catch it. When I execute this class file, then only the exception is thrown out by the compiler in the console of Eclipse, and it is showing me the type of exception, that is arithmetic exception, and this is the message of the exception, and this is the line number in which the exception is present. So that is why this is what exception is. That is, this kind of exception is called as unchecked exception. Next observation is that there are lines of code below the exception line. So the exception is present in line number 14. So if I click on this particular link which shows which the line in which the exception is present, I get the line highlighted. So if you see, there are lines of code below it. What is happening out here? For example, it might be possible that this line of code is important for us. Now what is going to happen? Since this line number 14 has exception, the lines of code below it will not get executed by the compiler. That means the compiler stops at this particular line. Okay, that is what was discussed, that when you have an exception in a particular line of code, whether it is checked or unchecked, right now it is an example of unchecked exception, the coding lines or the lines of code below it will not get executed by the compiler, and the compiler stops at this particular line in which the exception is found out. So that is why in the console of Eclipse you will not get the results for the variable G. Now it might be possible that these lines of code are important for us. Okay, so this is the line in which the exception is present. This is the println of the variable F. So anyways, this is not going to show you any kind of result. But these lines, line number 16 and 17, let's say it's important for us. So this line needs to be executed, and we need to get the result in the console of Eclipse. So what we need to do is that we need to handle this exception, which is coming in line number 14, with either a try catch block or a throws clause. Now this is an example of a checked, this is an example of unchecked. This is not checked exception, it's an unchecked exception. Okay, whether it is checked or unchecked, you can handle it with your try catch block or throws clause. And then after you handle it with your throws clause or with your try catch block, you'll be able to see the results of these lines in the console of Eclipse. And that is what I'm going to show you in the next part of this particular video. So let us go and look at that particular PPT. The next part of the example is exception handling example. So how do we handle exception? See, if you go to Eclipse right now, this is what the exception is coming. Okay, this is an example exception. So what I will do is that I'll create another class file inside the exceptions package, and I'll call this as exception handling. Call the main method. And what I'm going to do is that this particular class file has already exception. So what I will do, I'll copy these codes and put it out there in this particular code. That means I'm putting the copied code in this particular class file called exception handling. Now we know that if I run this particular class file, it is going to show me an exception in line number. Right now the line number is 13. And this is the type of exception, arithmetic exception, and the message of the exception is divide by zero. And if I also see an observation that I get a println for the variable C and variable D, which are the lines which are above line number 13, in which the exception is present. So I'm getting the result for, at least the compiler is able to compile these lines and throw the result in the console of Eclipse. That is what I'm getting this. But these below lines are not compiled by the compiler because line number 13 is an exception. And let's say it is important for us to get the result of this particular lines, line number 15 and 16, which comes after the exception present in line number 13. So I want to get the result of these. So what I need to do, I need to handle exceptions. How can I handle exceptions? I know this line has a problem, and that is what is shown in the console of Eclipse. Line number 13 has an exception, and the exception is called as arithmetic exception. How do I handle it? I can use the try catch block. Try, this is the body of try. So this is the line which has the problem, okay, and this is the result of the variable f. So I'll put these two lines inside the try block, and the try block is immediately followed by the catch block. It's in always in pair. Try catch block is always in pair. Catch block is followed by a parenthesis, and then you have the body part of the catch block. Now what is inside the parenthesis? What should be present inside the parenthesis? This should give you, you should actually pass out a object of the exception class. Exception is the inbuilt class of Java. You create an object of it. Let's say exception E. E is the reference variable of the exception class. Okay. And then inside the catch block, I can write down sysout. Just write down, this is the catch block body. First thing, that this is what I'm going to write down, and I've already used E, that is why it is showing me a duplicate parameter. So I'll call this as, for example, F is also being used, I believe, in this particular manner. So I'll, for the safe purpose, I'll call it that Z. Now since exception is a class, obviously every class will have methods. Two methods which are very frequently used as far as try catch block is concerned are these. One is, the if I use the reference variable of the exceptions class, that is Z, so Z dot, I'll get the methods of the exception class. One of the methods which is heavily used is the print stack trace method. This particular method, this method gives you the origin of the exception, that is the origin of the exception that is thrown out by line number 14 at this point of time. So it will print out the stack trace. It will do a stack tracing of the exception. That means it will basically throw out the origin of the exception coming in line number 14. This method is exceptionally used. And the other method which is used is your sysout Z dot get the message, get message method, and this will give me the message of the exception, whatever is the exception. Right now it is arithmetic exception, that is what is thrown out in the console of Eclipse. So it will give me the message of the exception if I want to. These methods are heavily used. Now what is going to happen, how it is going to work? Now I have put these two lines of code within the try block. So when the compiler moves from top to down, it encounters a try block. That means it understands that there might be a problem within the try block. This is the body of the try block. So it basically see and execute these and check out if these lines have, you know, exceptions or not. Right now it is an unchecked exception, whatever it is. It can also check for the try, the compiler can also check for checked exceptions inside the try block. So right now the try block has an exception which is an unchecked exception. It can also understand, or the compiler can also understand, if the try block or the body of the try block has checked exceptions also. So you'll find out there's an exception out here. So what is it is going to do? The moment it finds out there's an exception out here, it is going to move the control to the catch block and execute the body of the catch block. This is how it handles it. So it handles the exceptions coming out in line number 14. And if you see out here, line number 14 and 15 is part of the try block or body of the try block. So I can just put it like this, becomes easier. And what is going to happen, the compiler understands, oh, there is an exception in this particular line, but the exception type and the result will be thrown in the console of Eclipse. But when it compiles, it shows a try block. It becomes very much, the compiler becomes now kind of, you know, becomes attentive. So you understand that there might be a problem with the codes within the try block. So it finds out there is a problem, that there might be an exception, or there is an exception rather. So what happens is that it actually handles this particular exceptions, move the controls of the catch block, executes the body of the catch block, and then it executes these lines of codes too. So if I run the class file right now, I'll get the result of G also, plus I will also get these results which are above the exception. Plus, apart from this, I'm also going to get the result of the catch block, because the body of the catch block will get executed by the compiler. So the compiler moves from top to down, encounters a try block or try keyword, and becomes attentive. It finds out there is an exception. The exception will be caught by the compiler or handled by the compiler, and the compiler will move the control to the catch block, execute the body of the catch block. It will print out this particular part, it will print out the stack trace, that is the origin of the exception, that is arithmetic exception coming out in line number 14. It will print out the message of the exception again, and after that it will execute these parts. You'll get the result of these parts also. See, if you run the class file, you get it. This is the result of variable C and D, which you have seen earlier also. And if you see out here, you are getting, so what is happening, you are getting these two results, and when it comes, the compiler comes to try block, becomes attentive, it finds out there is an exception which is an unchecked exception. So it will basically handle that exception, move the control to the catch block, execute the body of the catch block. This is the first part that gets executed, and that is what you are seeing out here. Then it executes the print stack trace. The print stack trace is nothing but this part. So it will basically give you the type of exception coming in and the message of the exception. That is what the print stack trace will print. And then it will basically print out this part, the message. The message is divide by zero. This is the exception message. And then it will execute the println command, which is below it. That is the value of the exception. The value of G is 600. Because A into B means 30 into 20 is 600. This is how you handle exceptions using the try catch block.